And tens of thousands of Queenslanders have echoed those calls for tougher youth justice laws, particularly over the sentence given to the teenager who crashed into and killed Matthew Field, Kate Ledbetter and their unborn child. Today, the state government announced it is appealing the sentence. Tim Avier joins us with the details. Tim, Matthew Field's family has responded to that decision.
That's right, Melissa. They say this case should not become a political issue. Rather, they see it as a moral issue for all Queenslanders, saying the deaths of Matthew, Kate and their unborn son, Miles, should not be in vain. And while today's decision to appeal the verdict is a good start, they believe there is still a long way to go before new laws are introduced and changed to make sure other families don't go through what they have. After a week of community anger, the legal advice came back and the government's decision was no surprise.
That the grounds of appeal are that the sentence of manslaughter was manifestly inadequate, particularly as the judge had determined that the offence was a heinous offence.
The now 18-year-old, who was drunk, speeding and running red lights while on bail when he crashed into and killed the young family, could be out in just 6 years under his original sentence. The Attorney General says she understands the outrage.
Nothing is going to bring back Matt or Kate. And that is, I think, at the heart of why the community really have felt this so emotionally.
Matthew Field's parents say they're pleased an appeal is going ahead, but it's the first step of a long battle.
And until we get some sort of justice here, it will continue to be a blur. And even afterwards, it still may well be, but at least we will feel better that we've actually done something in our life to change these youth justice laws.
The Attorney General says since this tragic case happened, they have changed legislation and it's now harder for young offenders who commit serious offences to get bail.
Those reforms are working. More young people committing serious offences are not getting bail.
The opposition argues this sentence was only possible because Labor changed youth justice laws in 2018.
If he had committed this crime under the old laws when the LNP was in government, he would have been tried, charged and convicted and sentenced as an adult offender under the Criminal Code.
Tim Avia, Nine News.